people need bad people round them. Say them bad and them a post on Snapchat. Chatty mouth get a fat shot. You find them anywhere, any hot spot. Man need dark up your place if you black.
Say them bad and them a post on Snapchat. Yo, man, bless up peeps. You listen to the first episode of Reggae Talk, the voice of reason for the culture. You listen to yours truly, Reggae Music. And you might hear my co-host, call me Budan. You know the thing set, for real.
Yeah, man, I'm for real, you know, the realest. And this is the first podcast, and we're going to be talking some real perspectives from myself and the host, you know Budan.
Young one. You don't know, so we have to introduce everybody. Can't left out Infarable, the man behind the graphics, the man behind the images and all that great stuff that you've seen and that's coming. Info, say something.
Welcome and greetings, you know?
Yeah, man.
Greetings. That's all I'm can say right now.
Bless up. And you don't know, so we have to introduce. We got to introduce Dancehall Dave, a great super executive producer.
Yeah, man. Glad how the thing set, like how everything has sounded. I love all the love and you know, we getting on social media. Just a little preview that we put up already, and it's already seemed like everybody interested. You know,
yeah, man.
You know, very funny on your page. I saw one of your followers said, "Yo, I want in."
Yeah, I mean, you know what it is, man. You know how we do our thing different. So people appreciate it and people respect it. So we're gonna keep the fire blazing and turn up the fire notch. You know what I mean? But let's get right into it. Into it for real.
Big in eye.
All right, so this episode we're going to talk about social media, the influence of social media, specifically on artists, fans, disc jocks. All right.
So when we talk about social media, we're talking about particularly Instagram, Twitter, YouTube, Facebook, and if you know any other, you know, Snapchat, you know, all them things. If you know any other, you could, you know, you could definitely know exactly what we're getting into.
Yeah, man, the primary social mediums, more than one, Instagram, Twitter, and so forth. So here's a question I want to pose to you guys, all right? Has social media fueled hatred, bad blood, or division among dancehall artists, fans, and disc jocks? Yeah. Or has social media enhanced the hatred, bad blood, or has it really cultivated a division among dancehall artists, fans, or DJs? So that's what we're going to talk about this week. So let me just put a little context to this stuff before we get into it. All right, so everybody knows social media is great. Social media is a gift and a curse, right? I love social media. So it's a gift because it's easy, right? It's an easy way of communicating. It's transparent. It's brand new, cutting edge, right? And we can connect with everybody around the world at a snap of a finger within seconds. In fact, some millennials are, for real, what's the generation of millennials? What is it? Generation Z, right?
Yeah, so them say.
Generation Z. Then we tell us that, boy, social media is the greatest thing to mankind. Because that's what you know. Because remember, those people were born after the inception of the internet.
True.
So that's what they know. That's right. Their generation. Meanwhile, the millennials, we were around before the inception of the internet. You get what I'm saying?
True.
So you cannot tell them nothing about the internet or social media. So now, as you know, anywhere where a group of people are gathered, there's bound to be some kind of culture. That's inevitable. And on social media, millions, billions of people, they gather. So clearly, a culture will formulate.
I agree. No, I 100% agree. And we can see it. It's evident.
It's a way of life.
Right.
Culture is a way of life. So, you know, so that's inevitable. In some cases, on the social media, especially on Instagram, it's a culture of love. But oftentimes, what I'm seeing, what we've been seeing, is a culture of hate, especially when it comes to our dancehall and reggae music. So my question is, why is there so much hate and bad blood amongst fans, artists, and the like on social media? That's the culture that I'm seeing, a lot of hatred, you know?
All right, so let's dig into before pre-social media time.
Yeah, man.
How was that time from your perspective? What do you remember about before social media?
So before social media, I mean, as a youth growing up in the 90s or whatever, I mean, we all had our favorite DJs, whether it was Beanie Man. Who was your favorite DJ back in the day? Beanie Man, Bounty Killer.
Beanie was actually my favorite at back them time then.
Yeah,
and I actually remember like back in them times when, you know, having conversations, you know, just playing dominoes or certain things, having like debates with someone who was a Bounty Killer fan. And it would be more personal. It would be face to face. We have a, you know, a debate about Beanie Man or him say Bounty Killer the best. And then, you know, that would be the hour back then, pre-social media time.
Yeah. But would you say in retrospect,
right?
Would you say even though everyone had their artists who they favored, would you say, oh, Merciless?
Yeah.
Yeah, Ninja Man.
Yeah, yeah. You can't forget them one.
Boy, big up Ninja Man. Janu. Yeah. Big up Ninja Man. You know. But yeah, man, even though everyone had their artists, I would say in retrospect, there was still some culture of love. There was still some sense of oneness amongst all the stakeholders and dancers, whether it be fans, artists. Looking back, people, you tell me, there was still some sense of oneness. Today, I don't really feel the oneness, and we're going to get into that later on. All right? So for real, fast forward into the 2000s.
Yeah. Well, one thing that I did notice was with the Bounty Killer and the Beanie, Bounty did form alliance, and that because of the alliance, kind of start having groups of people who kind of took on to alliance. And you know, out of the alliance, who came out of alliance? The two giants.
You already know. So the whole group thing, no? Bounty formed the alliance, and then came, we all know,
the Gully and the Gaza.
The prolific Vibes Cartel, iconic Mavado. You understand? Gaza versus Gully. And I would say, one can argue that maybe the Gaza versus Gully rift was what really separated Dancehall. And we're still feeling the remnants of that Gaza versus Gully rift. And one can argue that that's really what separated the culture. And really what keeps it divided today. You get what I'm saying? So,
I mean, out of the Gully versus Gaza rose a whole lot of violence to the point where the prime minister had to step in and call a truce for this, because the violence increased tremendously in, you know, just being a part of the influence of music itself.
Yeah, man, it reached a point where people didn't even want to say if them are Gaza or Gully.
Back then,
you know, I mean, a man want to identify, because if I say you're Gaza, you know, a man will start praying. People start looking at you differently. Or if you say you're Gully, people start looking at you differently. It was bad. It was like it was really
rough.
It was good for the culture, but it was also bad.
Definitely.
You know what I mean? So to go forward, the new generation of dancehall fans, their most monumental dancehall memory is arguably Gully versus Gaza. You understand? So what do we expect?
Yeah, I mean,
separation, division.
Right. That's what they know. That's what they're going to show.
Yes.
Right.
I mean, if that's what you know, what do you expect? So basically, they came up in an era of division.
And that was the rise of social media, because that was the time when MySpace, Facebook all emerged and
everything
and
transcended.
Definitely.
Into what it has become today.
So you can call Gully Gaza a perfect timing for social media emergence.
Yeah, man, the timing was right. I agree with you.
Yeah.
Yeah, man. So let's get into the social media era now today. Fans, how many times have you been on Instagram, or you've been on Facebook, or you've been on whatever, on YouTube, what have you? People go out of their way. They go out of their way to plead their allegiance to their artist movement. Some people, them do it through badness, threats, name calling. You know what I say? What do you call these people? I always say, where were these people before they had social media, for real?
Oh,
where were they?
These people were there, but they just, social media gave them a platform.
Yes.
To voice their internet badmanism and their cyberbullying.
Yo, bro, the other day I was on somebody page. Mm-hmm. I was on somebody page, mm-hmm. and I think it was a post about Alkaline and Mataran.
Right.
And one person said, "Yo, Alkaline, you got dead when you if you come to New York."
Oh yeah, yeah, I mean, see that
you
one.
Saw that one, right?
Yeah, I saw that. Yeah.
I mean, countless ones.
No, it was but that
countless ones.
That particular one just stood out because it was
you
like
get what
a
I'm saying?
Direct threat to a direct place.
Yeah. So sometimes I see these extreme comments where people are just it's inexplicable. I don't get it.
Yeah, I
really don't get it.
I personally think these people wouldn't be saying these things, but because they're in the comfort of their homes behind a computer, they get the comfort to say whatever comes to mind. You know, sometimes I feel like they don't feel this way really and truly, but they're voicing hatred that, you know, is just in depth in them. And
all right. Yeah. So let me ask you this.
Yeah.
Would you say that they keep the feelings on that particular social medium? All the feelings come out in real life whenever they go to dance or shows
or
whenever. Yeah,
I mean, obviously, once you're carrying those, harboring those feelings on, you know, social media, you're gonna take it into the real reality.
Yeah, man.
So I mean, you're gonna go to dance, you're gonna hear a wicked song that from your opposing, you know, artist, and you're just gonna not give it no interest, not bust a blank, and be upset when you hear it. I mean, we saw the remnants of this in with the whole Mataran and Alkaline. You know, you see y'all have Alkaline bridging behind Mataran. I screw up the fierce and ready for slap off the man fierce. Should we play a like a cartel song? So, you know, it definitely comes
and,
out.
And then all the fans in the peanut gallery, mm-hmm. the peanut galleries, and all the people who are in the comments.
Oh,
you know, the hate is just multiplying, and definitely. It's just multiplying, and it's right. Like a competition. It's a competition to see which crew can butt up which crew. You get what I'm saying?
True.
So my question is, was there so much hate for artists and fans prevalent in dancehall culture before this technology?
Honestly, I don't think so. I think social media definitely did enhance it, especially because these days a lot of people are impressionable. They really don't have a stance on anything. They just watch what the majority of the popular people are saying and then flow with that what they're saying. So
you're right.
Yeah. So I think that definitely kind of engulfed the flame of hatred.
I like the way you put it, engulfed the flame.
Yeah.
Because once and then it not only remains a flame, it becomes a wildfire.
Oh yeah.
Because some people they really don't have a mind of their own.
Oh yeah, that's true.
They watch what other people are saying, and that's how they formulate their opinion. If some people comment before they comment, they got to watch what other people say.
Right, and then it becomes a thing of you're pleading your affiliation and not really even the music. It's not about the music anymore.
Now, yeah.
No, not because you plead your affiliation to Gaza. You hear an Alkaline song, you don't even want to give it its proper props. You know, so it, like, you know, I don't get it. I'm just so glad I don't have that, because when I hear a good song, it's all about the song. The song sound good. It's a good song. Yeah, I care less who affiliates with it.
And you know,
I'm pretty sure you feel the same.
You know which one really killed me?
Yeah.
All right. Yeah. A bad cartel song come out.
Yeah.
A bad Alkaline song come out.
I know there's a lot of them.
And you say, "Yo, bro, what do you think of this song?" Yo. A Gaza missa,
but the tune body no.
But the tune body no. A gully missa, but the tune brother nobody never asked. I never asked you.
I never asked you that.
I never asked you who you plead your allegiance to.
I just want
to
know if the song is good.
I want to know if the song is good. Mm-hmm. I want to know if the song is good. You get what I'm saying? Nobody cares about your biases and all those things. You tell me what to think about the song.
You know, I was watching a documentary from Massacre, Energy documentary. Faded did the documentary, and in the interview, he mentioned that the music can be bigger than the artist. So he made an emphasis of putting a brand behind him. When the brand was genocide, genocide and
I think he said a movement. Yeah, he
said he followed the hip hop trend of making a movement. So I guess this is what the artists are going with, and the people are just falling for it, like, you know, and what they're doing is they're
but you know what it, yeah. The hatred that's brewing, mm-hmm. is kind of like a byproduct of the movement.
Yeah, definitely. That's what I was getting.
It become damn near cult following.
Exactly.
Because Gaza Nation, yo, no romp with Gaza Nation.
That's some real cult.
No romp with Gaza Nation.
Oh, yeah.
That's some real cult following that.
Definitely.
You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm. Oh, no. And Vendetta, too.
Yo, Vendetta. Yeah. You know, romp with Vendetta.
Yeah. Angola, too.
But you know the interest? The other day I said to myself, where did Vendetta fans come from? Because Alkaline just came about. Who did they plead their allegiance to before Alkaline came on the music scene?
Oh yeah, I mean it definitely
many of them were cartel fans.
Right, that's why it puzzles me. They gotta pick a side, and
here we go again.
They're confused.
Here we go again. So that goes back. You said pick a side. That goes back to what how we started the podcast. That it's a generation of division. Gully versus Gaza, where people feel they need to pick a side as opposed to promoting oneness.
Right. And the unity would build the dancehall reggae music into a whole nother level. Because there's a pie out there for everyone to eat. So
there's food there for every man. Food there for everybody,
so,
man.
You know what I mean? So thing just for unite. I mean, that's what I stand for.
Unity.
Yeah.
All right. So let's go a little bit further. Okay, you know, reggae talk is all about the voice of reason. We bring perspective. We dig beneath the surface.
Right.
So we're going to delve beneath the surface a little bit further. Yeah. So now, for whatever reason, there's something about this culture where fans just seem to always feel a sense of belonging. They got to feel like they belong to a crew. And they identify with a crew. And they're going to let you know that that's who I plead my allegiance to.
Right.
You get what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Why is that?
You know, it's a funny question because...
Why do you think...
I remember before social media times, Jamaican, you know, our people, Jamaican, we pled to political affiliates, you know?
Yeah.
So it could PNP versus JLP, still to this day, mm-hmm. maybe not as much as back then, but... It definitely has something to do with it. We've been doing it from before social media time. You know, maybe many of these artists seen this and said, you know what, that's the power I want to have. I want to be a politician, for dancehall in a sense.
Absolutely. So, you're saying that this stems from the partisan, whatever you call it, the partisan ideals in Jamaican culture.
Yes.
Where people feel that, you know what? You got to pick a side.
Yeah, 100%.
One-sided prejudice. Yo, a JLP, me say, or a PNP, me say, Labour.
And we could go even further. Power. And say it's tribalism.
Absolutely.
You know, we're all from Africa.
One can argue that it's tribalism as well.
Right.
People, let us know what you think. Because there's something about this culture that somewhere... Something that's deep within us where we feel that we must identify with something, you know? Because no matter what your artists do, whether it's good or it's bad, your artist is the greatest thing since sliced bread. And my thing is that a spade is a spade. Right. If you're my artist and you're not doing what you're supposed to do, as a matter of fact, let's talk about real life.
Right.
If you're my friend and I love you, I should be able to say, yo, listen, bro, you're messing up.
Definitely. 100%.
You're messing up.
Right.
So if your artist is messing up, if your artist is not doing what he's supposed to do, your artists are going with a bug of arms, those. You're supposed to say, yo, you're my artist, Maria, and I respect you,
but
you are not doing what you're supposed to do.
Right.
But in dancehall, what I see is that their artist is not doing what they're supposed to do, and they're still backing the nonsense.
100%. Yeah.
Yeah, a Gaza would say, a Gully would say.
No, they played their loyalty 100%.
Yeah,
wrong or right.
Yeah, and that's the same thing in politics.
Yeah,
it's the same thing in politics because your MP or whoever MB, you might go on with a bag of things. You know within yourself, say yo, you might go on with a bag of things, but because that you born and grew in, that's what you subscribe to. You can't say otherwise. And I think it trickles down to...
It's a form of brainwash.
It trickles down to the dancehall culture itself. You get what I'm saying? People, let us know what you think.
I mean, I actually remember Cartel saying that he's playing the people like they're sheep. And he's like the shepherd.
Manipulated people.
I remember him saying that. You know, I'm not trying to call out nobody. You know, I don't want you, Gaza Nation, attacking me here, but I'm just talking facts.
Gaza Nation, I come for you.
Boy.
So, yeah, man, but Jamaicans, everyone knows this. Jamaicans take their politics very serious, and they'll go out of their way to let you know what they represent or who they represent. That's just the way of life in this culture. You get what I'm saying?
All right, let's talk about the artists. What part does the artist play on this division that's going on in the enhancement in social media?
The artists?
Yeah.
Well, nowadays there's no sting anymore. There's no warring on stage, lyrical war on stage.
Well,
physical war?
Well, a long time we don't see the physical.
A long time we don't see that still.
Yeah. We don't want to see that neither.
We don't want to see that.
Lyrical.
A long time. Yeah, man. But what's going on with the artists? So how are they cultivating this culture of hate right now among and how are they fueling this fire, enhancing this culture of hate via social media? Artists, what they're doing right now instead of warring.
The subliminals.
They throwing subs
on IG.
You say popcorn. What popcorn did the other day?
Oh, yeah.
Popcorn chew a little sub.
Oh,
Alkaline chew a fame little sub.
Yeah, man.
He throw his sub too. I mean, it goes on and on and on.
I mean, even go further, we're going to talk about Aishana and
Diana Dia.
And when Aishana went in and talk about Dion's mom,
that was
disrespectful to the fullest, but it was through social media.
And guess what? Yeah. People came on my page and people told me, people like, yo, you know, they made up all kind of excuses.
She went too far, but people were trying to make excuses for her actions.
And then the bullying and the hatred, like, people were just going on and on and on, and it was just so much hate, so much hatred. And I'm wondering, where were these people before social media? If we never had this platform, if we never had this medium of Instagram, Facebook, YouTube, would these people be carrying on in the fashion that they were carrying on a couple months ago? This is real life stuff.
Real life.
You get what I'm saying?
And I feel like because these artists feel like now it's a social media war, there's like no limits. It's like now they feel like, all right, I don't have to buck them on, right? That's all again. So now I could just talk all the much I want on social media, and that plays a part on it as well. And they want to, you know, they want to remain relevant. That's another reason why. You know, social media is a platform where people are going to grab the bait, and then it's going to be on all the blogs by morning. They're going to be relevant. They're going to be on all the blogs, and people are going to be talking. So they try as much as they can to generate that controversy.
It's like, and it's kind of like a divide and conquer.
Yeah.
And once you start using the divide and conquer strategy, that's a breeding ground for hate. That's a breeding ground for hatred.
True.
You get what I'm saying? And people, don't get me wrong. There's a lot of love on social media, but it's just that I see a lot of hate.
Definitely.
It's just like the hate is like, it's just alarming to me. It's just alarming to me, so.
Yeah, I mean, it's definitely enhanced. Social media has enhanced the hatred. But once we make it, we make ourselves aware of it, we can be knowledgeable. It's like being awoke, you know. And I want this is our job is to awaken the typical fan, so they can
think,
yeah.
Go dig beneath the surface, right. And say to yourself, "Yo, listen, what am I really doing? What am I doing? You know, what am I co-signing?" It's just if one were to ask me, it's just cyberbullying. It's cyberbullying.
Definitely cyberbullying.
It is cyberbullying, and guess what? Cyberbullying spills over into real life.
Real. It's true.
And cyberbullying doesn't only occur amongst kids. It happens with grown people. Because if you're on social media popping a whole bunch of junk about a certain person or a certain artist or a certain disc jockey or whatever, and then you end up, you got a dance and you book a man and a man say, "Yo,
we see it every day on the news.
On the news every day. So again, let's go back to how we started. The question was, just to remind people, has social media enhanced or fueled hatred, bad blood, or division among dancehall fans, artists, or disc jocks?
We didn't really touch much on disc jocks, but we'll give you guys the opportunity if you could comment and DM us and let us know your opinions on this. And so, we appreciate your feedback as well.
Yeah, man. So, peeps, I hope this this episode made you think. I hope this episode enlightened you somewhat, awakened some kind of a level of consciousness. You get what I'm saying? That's what we call ourselves, the voice of reason for the culture. This is not really like a Gaza podcast or what have you. A spade is a spade, and we call it how we see it. You get what I'm saying?
Yeah, be sure to follow Reggae Talk, and make sure to follow AKA For Real and Reggae Music.
Yeah, man. You can follow me on Instagram at Reggae Music Forever, and follow the podcast page at Reggae Talk. And also on SoundCloud, Reggae Music Forever. Eventually, we'll be on YouTube and iTunes, the whole work, Apple Music, what have you. All right? So until next time, peeps, remember, build each other up and don't tear each other down. In the name of reggae and dancehall music, one love, one culture.